Hey guys, it's Tom at Stormbreaker Films with another quick capsule review. I just wanted to first share this scene from The Marine, starring John Cena and this lovely man, Robert Patrick, aka the T-1000. This scene had me laughing till I was hoarse in the throat the first time I saw it, because it's literally Robert Patrick crossing the street, and it takes 13 shots to do it. Here we go. All right, 1, 2, 3. Four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Did he make it? Yes, he made it. 13. Oh, so good. All right, nerds to that. Boop, 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 boop. Oh, BB cameo. Anyway, here we are. So yeah, that movie, I caught The Marine like late night one night, and it was a delight. There's some scene where John Cena was like hanging off the side of a moving truck, and there were just sparks flying from the side of this moving truck as it brushed by trees for some reason. Like, the trees were just sparking up a storm. Forgive me a second, I'm setting up my camera. Worst camera in the world, let's not forget. Okay, there we go. So, yeah, The Marine, amazing. You know, it's oversized, it's ridiculous, it's all American, and it's kind of wonderful in a way. It was a WWE production, so I think it even started with, like, the 20th Century Fox fanfare and then cut to a WWE logo. Which, by the way, you can tell a Star Wars movie's canon if there's 20th Century Fox fanfare in front. So this is some of the action movies that John Cena has been producing lately under the Hefty brand. I mean, pretty amazing. It's good stuff, man. He commands a good performance. But yeah, The Marine, just a generic, as generic as it could get, without actually having Jeff Fahey in it. It had kind of a shitty Brian Bosworth and the Smoke Jumper movie feel to it, but ultimately, you know, it was a kidnapping chase movie, and it kind of worked. It was fine. It had some really bizarre humor in it, or at least attempts at it, but it was all right. So that's my quick capsule review of The Marine. Next, we go to Drag Me to Hell, which... Actually, it got on my radar because of this Scream magazine had an article about Wolfen, of all things, which was, you know, the first Hollywood upcycling movie that we reviewed, and I started looking through the other articles, and I was like, ooh, Alison Lohman, I remember her. She never did that much, but she's super cute, so I wanted to check it out. And it's typical Sam Raimi, it's very Looney Tunes in the physics. I don't see how anyone finds Sam Raimi movies scary in the least. They're just funny. And I think he even probably would acknowledge that himself, especially the ones he co-writes with his brother Ivan. Like, they're just straight over the top ridiculous. The Drag Me to Hell had maybe one of the worst plot holes I've ever seen, which is that you have this, you know, woman who works as in a bank. She's a loan officer, and she's vying for position as an assistant manager. So you'd think she'd be very detail-oriented, and yet she, at one point, a critical juncture in the movie, drops an envelope and doesn't check its contents, and it may or may not cost her a soul. You know, it seemed a little out of character for that personality type. But anyway, yeah, it was ridiculous. Not the best effort by Sam Raimi. But it had some enjoyable performances. So let's see what's next. Finally, quick capsule review. We're going to look at The Shallows, and I had very shallow reason to watch this. I wanted to see Blake Lively's sweet ass, and I wanted to see sharks, and I wanted to see it in that order, and they delivered exactly that. this movie turned out to be a little gem. Let's watch a little of the trailer for The Shallows. And then I'm going to make a shocking, possibly deal-breaking revelation. I mean, the cinematography, it wasn't actually very exploitative of Blake Lively. She did a good job. She had a very likable and fairly three-dimensional character for this kind of genre film. It reminded me a lot of The Reef, the premise of The Reef, which was another film that was supposedly based on a true story. So yeah, I quite like this movie. As a matter of fact, I liked it way more than I thought I would. The cinematography was absolutely on point and amazing. It didn't look cheap in the least, even though it was a Sony film, and a lot of the movies that they produce are actually Adam Sandler like con jobs more so than real movies. But yeah, this had a great premise. Basically, she's at a beach. Her surfing partner gets drunk and has the Irish flu. Doesn't show up, so she's out there alone with a couple. Meets a couple locals, but she gets stuck. Here in the trailer, they show her getting stuck right on the coral atoll at low tide. But as a matter of fact, the first place she gets stuck is on top of a bloated whale that was being fed on by gulls, one of whom she befriends, sort of like Wilson from Castaway. So it was pretty incredible. I actually would probably rank this in maybe my top three shark movies. And I love shark movies. I'll at least try something, even if it looks like Drek. But yeah, I thought it was really well done. That the shark looked amazing. You know, it I think will age pretty well, even though some of the CGI is a little rough. But yeah, just the tension was Hitchcockian at times. Just incredible. I really loved it. I would recommend The Shallows wholeheartedly. I'm gonna put it up there with my number one shark movie is Deep Blue Sea. My number two is Jaws, and I'm gonna say number three is The Shallows. So, all right. Anyway, that's it for today. Bye.